First-class tyres deserve first-class mounting. The installation work of Nokian tyres should be carried out strictly according to instructions to prevent any risk of injury or damage to the tyres and equipment. The little extra effort pays off with a long, trouble-free tyre life and safe working environment, plus the satisfaction from doing the best job possible. Here's the correct procedure for installing a typical forestry tyre. Check that the rim really is suitable for the tyre at hand. Check that the tyre is of correct type. Mistakes can happen. Also check the tyre for any manufacturing defects and make sure that the bead area that sits against the rim is in perfect condition. At this point, you should decide whether the tyre is meant for the right or left side of the vehicle. Observe the direction of rotation marked on the tyre. Before mounting, check that the rim is clean and in good condition. Apply some grease to inside the tyre and inside bead that goes towards the assembly machine. Take a suitable inner tube and check the tube for any defects. Remove the valve cap and nut. Attach an inflation hose. Put the tube inside the tyre and fill it partly. Make sure that the valve stem is on the correct side. Apply some grease to the outer side bead area of the tyre, as well as on the inside of the inner tube. Grease properly inside the rim, as well as the flanges. Drive the first flange of the rim inside the tyre. Press the tyre gently and rotate the rim. Drive the rim through the tube while rotating it. Adjust the position of the valve stem close to the valve hole on the rim. Put a valve stem puller tool through the rim hole and attach it to the tube valve stem. Don't forget to put the valve nut inside the stem puller tool. First, attach a small mounting clamp to the rim flange right from the valve hole. Make sure to tighten it properly. Rotate the rim about 90 degrees and attach the bigger mounting clamp developed by Nokian tyres. The correct distance between these two clamps equals the distance between four lugs. Make sure to tighten the second clamp properly as well. Check one more time that the bead area is greased well. Rotate the rim so that the tyre mounting clamp is at the top. Drive the mounting head between the rim and the tyre bead. Press the tyre with the mounting head to pull the bead into the rim assembly groove. Make sure the tyre bead stays in the rim assembly groove by pulling the mounting head slightly downwards. This is very important to ensure correct mounting. Rotate the rim while moving the mounting bead slowly up, down and sideward to help the bead slip over the rim flange. Pull the mounting head off with the help of a bar. Make sure it doesn't damage the bead area. By turning the rim while pushing the tyre against the floor, you can precisely line up the valve stem and the valve hole. Then attach the valve nut and remove the valve stem puller tool. Wipe off extra grease, fill the tyre to the correct bead seating pressure. At the beginning of inflation, slightly push the tyre sidewall with the dismounting plate to remove air between tube and tyre. Take extra care not to exceed the pressure indicated by the tyre markings. Next, attach the valve core and inflate the tyre to the final pressure in a safety cage. Finally, attach the valve cap and the possible valve shield, and you're all set. A first-class job.